Hello, my name is Ian Ward, and I am a product manager and architect for mobile here at MongoDB. And today I'm going to show you some of the cool capabilities of MongoDB Realm, including our synchronization. So the first thing I'm going to show you is how to synchronize your MongoDB documents with a mobile application that is enabled with Realm Sync. So what I'm going to do here is I'm going to show you how to set up a MongoDB Realm app, set up the documents you want to sync, and then set up the MongoDB Realm client on the mobile side. And then we're going to show you how to set up the partition key, send it to the MongoDB Realm, and then what's going to happen there is it's going to grab the documents that match there and then send them down to the client. From there, I'm also going to set up a static HTML page in MongoDB Realm on the hosting tab. And then from there, I'm going to connect it to a webhook, which is a JavaScript function. We're going to put some code in there, which will insert a document that matches the partition key value we've already set up before. And that should automatically reflect down to the Realm Sync enabled client. And you'll see that new insertion go automatically for you. So without further ado, let's get started. If I am on my Atlas page here, my cloud page, I just spun up a new cluster, cluster 4. It's 4.4 MongoDB version. I'm going to click Stitch here, which will now be branded Realm. I'm going to create a new application here. I'm going to say booth demo, link to cluster 4, create the Realm application. Now from here, what we'll do is we'll create that schema. So you can see it's a completely new MongoDB Atlas database cluster. So I haven't set up anything yet. So I'm going to go add a collection. I'm going to say my test as my database name, create, and then I'll go dog. I'm going to sync some dogs today. And then I'll go add collection. Great. Now I'm also going to add a schema here. This schema is important. This is in JSON, but it's also going to show up in, I'm going to use an iOS or in Swift app to sync, and you're going to want to match these schemas together. So what I'll do here is I'll save this. You can also see if I go to my SDKs page here, it'll actually give you what you need here. So if I go to Swift, you'll actually see this dog class set up as well. So I can just take this, I'm going to paste it into my iOS app. I'm going to go to users. I'm going to enable anonymous users just to make it easy for a demo. And I'm going to sync. I'm going to sync, cluster 4. So the partition key is how you separate data on your MongoDB Atlas cluster into different partitions for the Realm clients to connect to. So I'm going to go Realm ID. I'm going to make this very permissive here, read and write true, so we can go back and forth. And then I click enable sync. From here, you review and deploy the changes. Deploying changes. Looks like it's all good. Right now, I'll need this app ID, so I'll copy that. And looks like its connections have started, so I'll go over to my Xcode. There's a couple different things I need to set up here. So one is this Realm app configuration. I'm going to put my app ID directly in there. So booth demo gives you a little string after. Realm.mongodb.com is the URL. You can see I'm going to save that, and then I'm going to build it. Now, the real content here is on this page here, content view. You can see this is the exact same schema we set up before. Looks like it's connected. If I click add, give it a dog, Billy, and a breed. Click add dog. Okay. Now, if we go back to my Atlas cluster, this is cluster 4.
I'll refresh this page for my collections. You can see my test, dog, and you can see there's my document. Now let's edit this and test the bi-directional synchronization. So I'll click Billy 2, click update. If I go back, you see it updates automatically. So there's not too much code here at all that has to do with route. There's the class, the dog class. If I go down here, this is the add button. So I'm just creating a dog object and setting up the name and breed that is entered in here. And then I just wrap this in a realm.write transaction. There's no networking code whatsoever that you need here. We do all of the synchronization for you. In fact, this is all you need to do. You have a realm reference, you have a configuration. That partition value is very key because this is how we delineate this set of documents is for this mobile app. And then another user might have a different partition key value that they sync on. This is how you kind of delineate between the two users. Okay, so now let's go add a webhook to this. Now what we're gonna go on third-party services, add a service, I'm gonna click HTTP, say post dog, add the service. We're gonna add an incoming webhook. Call post dog again. System, we'll unpack the functions. Let's go over to the editor. Put it in here, and you can see what I'm doing here is I'm gonna take the payload, parse it. I'm gonna connect to my Atlas cluster, my dog collection. I'm gonna take the payload, I'm gonna insert it in there, right? I'm gonna make sure that it matches up with that partition key value so that it syncs down to the mobile device. We'll take that, we will save this, and we will deploy it. Great. Now from here, what we'll need to do is in order to have this in a static HTML, we'll take this webhook URL and go back to an HTML, static HTML, and we'll find this because what this is going to do is present an HTML to the browser. And we need to make sure that it's going to the right webhook. So right here, you'll see that it takes the webhook URL with the command. It is up here. Paste it in there, save. Now, if I go back to Stitch, I'll go to hosting, enable hosting. And get rid of this. Then what I'll do, get my HTML, drag it on here. Loads, let's deploy. And let's open this in a browser. So this is very simple HTML. You can see I just put in the document right here, send it. It says insert it. If I go back, you can see Teddy right there, right? You can kind of see this is how you can build a multi-platform application, both browser and mobile, that has the same shared back end and allows a bi-directional synchronization to the mobile. I hope you enjoyed this, and I hope you give it a chance to try it out.